Hello and welcome to Antelope TV. We got a special day today because we've got Andrew in from Antelope Audio.
What's up, man?
Being good.
Yeah.
Andrew's been in the store doing an in-store event, so we had some customers come in and check out the range. And I think I'm in a good place for this video. Maybe if you're the same and you haven't heard of Antelope Audio, I'm sure loads of people out there have as well. I'm in that camp that doesn't know much about it, so I was hoping that Andrew could just take us through the range today and tell us why Antelope Audio are so badass, as his colleague Igor pointed out. So let's start. What do you want to tell us about Antelope Audio?
First of all,
everything, the whole world.
I want to thank you for being here. For us, it's such an honor being invited for a second time in Andertons. The company as a company started its business from the quaking technologies and from the mastering converters at the start. The first as a product was the quarks, as a master quarks and rubidium atomic quarks. This was...
And they're like master clocks, will it? And
yeah.
Converters, right, okay, serious
the
stuff.
The converters are later. The first was the actual master quarks, which was our product flagship for the past 10 years.
Right.
Then we have decided to introduce high-end DACs and also to introduce mastering ADDA converters on the market.
Yeah.
This was from the years to 2007 to 2012.
And cool.
After that, we have jumped to the audio interfaces industry because our success with the master quarks and with the synchronization technology was so big that we have decided just to move forward, because for us it's important not to stay at one place, but to continue growing as a company. And that's why I'm here for today.
Good for us musicians and you out there musicians, because that whole idea of the, so you come from a really high-end background in mastering, and basically interfaces allow us clam-handed fools to plug in and record some music. You've got it set up with your laptop here as well. Do you want to start at what the entry level is for us? Like if I wanted to get into and like myself, what's the kind of smallest? Is it the Tour we've got going?
Yes, what we are going at the moment, this is the smallest portable and the newest audio interface from our portable range. It's called Zen
That's
Tour.
Good. Newest and smallest, Zen Tour.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks lovely. It looks substantial.
Thank you so much. It has a couple of Tech Award nominees, and also it has a music radar.
Oh, so it's won some awards already. That's cool.
Yeah.
And run me down, who's that aimed at, this one?
Well, frankly and practically, to be honest, it's aimed to everyone.
Cool.
We have customers who are just starting it and buying, using it, you know, and just using it as a start.
Yeah.
Then we have pro audio studios who just get it as a addition to the bigger range.
They want to take that quality out on the road with them. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what we do actually. We don't compromise when it comes to the audio quality, and that's why even when you get the Zen Tour, you're not sacrificing from our ADDA conversion and the Supreme Quaking, which we empower with all of our products.
Oh, nice, Matt. Well, it looks great. I love this screen on it. Do you want to talk us a bit through about some of the features on the Zen Tour?
Yes, I would love to.
Yeah,
so the Zen Tour, you know, despite the fact that it's quite portable, it's really powerful interface. You have 8 preamps, 4
cool.
on the front here, which are
right.
high Z line.
Oh, right, nice.
And
yeah.
4 on the back, which are
quite a lot. It doesn't look like it would have that even on first glance. I was like, oh, wow.
Yeah, we have aimed to few of the places, you know, we have aimed to bring more to the customers that, you know, are used to get portable and small amount of I.O. We don't want to do that. We want to escape from it. We
and just, no breakout cables. It's cool.
No. The idea was to be stable and sturdy. That's why no breakout cables.
Most definitely,
for this
yeah.
one.
Yeah. Serious stuff.
We really like the design, and we have spent a lot of time of find our way when it comes to designing the gear.
Yeah.
But we believe that we have achieved it, because all of our interfaces are rock solid, and we're proud of it.
They're quite handsome as well.
Thank you.
I think you got a handsome interface.
We need to send regards to our graphic designers and to the R&D department as well.
Oh yeah, my boy is a graphic designer. I like it, and I like the Antelope. I like, what does that do? What does that button do?
Well, this button do is actually it's a multifunctional button.
Oh, that's cool.
You may change the functions of the button.
I don't know if you can see it on the camera. We've got a wicked button with a little antelope. like mid-air. I just think that's cool.
At this stage, the function basically changes the monitor out of the device, because this device comes with the two separate monitors.
Oh yeah,
and it
changed the screen. Great screen. So we got eight ins, analog ins there.
Yeah, if you press here, touch, and there is Antelope button here.
Yeah.
If you press it, you might just change the filter.
Dreamy. I've knocked us off course. So we got the eight ins. Looks like we got a couple headphones.
In addition to the 18s, this, you know, doesn't end with the device. You have two headphone outputs.
Yeah.
You have two reamp outputs, which are perfect for reamping all these amps with your already recorded guitar. You have eight line outs on the back, which is also good if you want to spread more headphone out mixes. If you have headphone amps,
yeah,
it's great if you can plug it here.
So not only have you got the two powered ones,
you have eight additional lights on the back as well.
Oh, like on a DIN
type. On a DSIP.
Yeah, oh, that's it. Yeah, nice, man. Oh, cool. And how's it? That's going in via USB. Dreamy.
It's a hybrid audio interface. Not only over USB, it works under Apple certified Thunderbolt as well. So
love the Thunderbolt. That's cool. For anyone with a Mac, it's nice because it's a spare port.
Yes.
Yeah, it's nice to clear things up.
It's
nice,
a spare
man.
Port. We're really proud that we have achieved this multi-platform connectivity, because most of the companies sacrifice one port for the others. With us, this has never been the case. We are aiming for both users, because we know how important it is to do music. It doesn't matter on which operating system.
Yeah, it's nice. We've got a PC in it. I haven't seen a PC for a while, but it's been working great. You've set it all up. And we shouldn't get too bogged down in the ins and outs. Sorry to ask you about it, because obviously you can go read about those. But it is amazing for you to just show me how much stuff in there, because it doesn't look like it at first glance. But the other thing is, this software looks great as well.
Thank you.
And touchscreen. What can the touchscreen... Why did you put the touchscreen on this... such a small device? Is it because it works in standalone mode, or is that it? Or?
Yes, it can also work as a standalone mode. You have a hardware embedded presets, which means that you can set up the software as it is. I can unplug the cable then, and you can continue playing with the device. And the hardware presets are taking care of storing this memory within the actual unit. So when you take off the cable, you will have the same features.
That's cool. And this screen is the best thing I've ever seen on a small interface. There's some that do the standalone thing, and then you need like a separate iPad and things like that, but that's cool that you got it on there.
Yeah, the screen was kind of a jump from the traditions and the small screens that, you know, many of us are used to see, and also the small peak meters that many interfaces are empowering. The screen basically controls all of the functions that you can ask from it. The only thing that it cannot is the routing, but that's why we have a beautiful software for the computer.
Yeah, let's have a look at this bad boy.
On it, yeah. So what we're seeing here currently is the main control panel of the Zen Tour.
Right.
Yeah. Inside it, you have all, which includes the actual unit. By all, I mean this is the routing section, and this is the basic control sections for the preamps, for the headphones.
Like the way they look like channel strips, like old channel strips. Cool,
yes,
man.
Our idea was to keep it known for the user, but to introduce our own way when it comes to the routing. Actually,
it looks posh. Do you know what I mean? Like, it looks expensive.
Yeah, the other word for posh is la-di-da as well.
Oh, it's la-di-da? Right.
Yeah. So, the routing matrix is the most powerful that I've seen, that I've used so far. I'm not saying that because I work for Antelope. I'm saying this because it's really easy. It's just a fact. It's really easy to work with it. It's divided in two sections. You have the sources, so the actual signal sources.
What's going in,
and the outputs. That's it. Everything is color-coded, and everything...
Like an amazing patch bay.
Digital patch bay. That's what I used to say it. It's pretty simple. What you have to do when you want to do something, simply drag and drop. Like in our case, if I just highlight certain channels, let's say that we want to send the preamps...
Eight channel, yeah.
Yeah, the preamps somewhere.
Down to mix one, and that's literally...
That's it.
I dig that. I can imagine, I've never seen it done like that way. It's a really nice way to do about it. Like grabbing cables and going, right, I'm going to plug it in.
The same as a patch bay. The idea is to, you know, keep it simple and not waste time. Because imagine if you have a normal wide mixing software-based yeah. control panel, and you have 200 channels, which one of the devices has in our range. What you do with it, you need to scroll down every day.
And is this software, because it says the Zen Tour there, is this software similar for all your interfaces across, or does it change?
Yes, actually it is quite similar, because the product line when it comes to the software does not change this a lot, because we want to keep it simple for
and
the
users. And that
brings
us on nicely. Let's not get too bogged down, because obviously we're going to look at an introduction really into Antelope, and we've been in the store, I think I asked, about a year, so we've been selling them. And I know that Brad, who's the high-tech manager, is a big old fan. He's a big fan of it. And the guys in the store seemed really happy with their products today. So we got this chat, and should we just talk up through the range or wherever you want to go, man?
Yeah, the newest piece of audio interfaces are still coming out. We have one ready for you guys here.
Cool.
It's called the Orion 32 HD, which
handsome.
Is this handsome piece here. What is unique about it, we're really proud of making such product, because it is first fully functional Pro Tools HD ready interface with two digiports or HDX ports.
Right.
You can record up to 64 channels over these ports into Pro Tools and back from Pro Tools. It also have a USB 3 inside it, which also is able to record 64 channels of simultaneous I/O in and out. You also have a MIDI interface inside it, which also allows you to transfer 64 channels I/O of MIDI.
Mm.
And the best part is that this Orion 32 HD also has 32 physical inputs and outputs on the back over this sub. So it's a one new device which empowers all of these digital and hardware I/Os within itself.
Wow.
This is not the only thing which makes the Orion really powerful tool within each studio. The other stuff are the legendary and supreme clocking technology, which our master clocks provided to the users for the past years. And we have taken advantage of this one.
Mm-hmm.
And we have equipped all of our interfaces with the latest clocking technology from Antelope Audio.
I'll see you just kind of upped the... You said the clocking technology.
Yeah, basically we use a special oven-controlled clocking system, which basically keeps the clock into a stable temperature, mm-hmm. which produces best results. And we use special algorithm.
Wow, so the temperature really makes a difference.
Yes, yes, it does.
Wow,
this is our way of using and utilizing the clocks. You know, I always want to say to the customers, and I'm always saying that even if you have the same quark into the each devices, the importance is how you can take the most out of it. Even if you have the same converters mm-hmm. within the two audio interfaces from the different brands, the important thing is just to make it work better. Mm-hmm. And this is what we're good at. We want
pushing forward.
Yes,
yeah.
And also I wanted to say something else about the Orion 32 HD.
Yeah.
It's also utilizes not only the quarking, but it has the latest FPGA power technology from Antelope Audio, which is a real time.
I heard about, sorry to jump in, FGPA.
FPGA.
FPGA. I did a synth demo earlier on today, and that had the same thing. Is it like a new type of processor?
It's not a new type of processor,
okay.
It's just
powerful.
Yeah, very powerful processor, which is running on logical algorithms, and basically it operates faster than the normal DSP engines. So it allows us to model vintage equalizers, compressors, and guitar amps real time within our devices. The Zen Tour has it, the Orion 32 HD has it, the Goliath, the Orion Studio, and the Orion 32 Plus, and the Orion 32. More or less, they have the same core technology, because the FPGA actually takes care not only for the real-time processing of the effects, but it takes care for the routing and of other important major aspects on the device. This is the core from our which handles our devices.
And I heard it earlier on the synth, so I'm looking forward to it, because on the synth, it really sounded amazing. God knows what you've been able to do with the stuff that's running in there. Should we get to, we got a guitar plugged in, haven't we? And,
mm-hmm.
and would that be using Because you said we could get the guitar plugged in. Yeah. Is that using the FPGA stuff to run amp modeling?
At this moment, what we have done so far is that I have set it up so-called layering within our devices, which means that I can make your guitar to be recorded without any effects. At the same time, I will pass it on to the effects. We can record it without affecting the first original source. And at the same time, if we just change, we can record the amp, which is plugged behind me.
All right, cool.
With
let's have a go at that. We'll get try crowbar.
You'll have to forgive
some like ham-fisted licks.
Okay.
I've got Pete's lovely Telecaster.
Currently, what we're hearing is the pure conversion of the unit. I mean, no processing is made.
So that's just dry?
Yeah, just dry.
God, it's a nice guitar, isn't it? Okay, so that's just dry.
And a nice unit as well.
Yeah, yeah.
It translates well.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Because normally it sounds... That's dry as a bone, just a DI in, right?
Yeah, the...
Cool.
The idea of our company is to bring the natural sounding into your computer as much as possible, because many units will, many other units may squash the sound, may just distort it a little bit, may twist it a little bit. But the idea here is just to bring the actual feeling that your fingers are touching the frets and it is being recorded.
Yeah.
I mean, this is the important stuff everyone in the music industry is achieving, is trying to achieve that.
I can tell you're really passionate about it, man, and I can hear it. I'm getting the sense from it as well. So that's dry in there.
Yeah.
Shall we, so do you have like any amp modeling or anything in there?
Yeah,
let me
show you something.
Yeah, hit me.
The first thing that we will do is that we will just pass this guitar through our BAE 1073.
Okay.
Boost.
Yeah.
And this is with only few small tweaks, which you know are needed to get the sound right.
Yeah.
If we go even deeper, we can achieve different results. But I think that the small adjustments matters when it comes to the recording.
And this BAE, are these licensed?
Yeah, of course. We are the only company currently who owns the licenses for them, which
that's a cool company to be hooked up. I didn't know that.
Yeah, they're a really good friend of ours. I'm sending the regards to them as well.
BAE, what?
They do amazing hardware products, and we're really proud of being in such cooperation with them.
That's cool. I think that obviously, you know, your pedigree in the mastering world, it's almost, I think that's amazing. And this chap, you can actually expand as well. If you want to do more people, it's got the ADAT stuff as well. So even a small bit of this could integrate into one of the bigger systems, right?
Yes, the cool part is that when we introduce a new device on the market, we look in the future of like how this device can be integrated into other systems, or how other systems can integrate with this device.
Yeah.
So in addition to the abundance of the hardware I/O, the Zen Tour has 16 ADATs on the side. So you have 16 ADATs input.
Cool. So I've always got to check for myself.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Which is ideal for just sending signals out to your digital mixing desks, or sending signal ins from a preamp.
Yeah, I've done the same. Like I've bought cheaper preamps that I've kind of ADATed in, maybe for toms, just for extra channels. And that's so good to have that feature, man.
Yeah, when you want to expand your channel count, it really matters to have extra connectivity over the good old ADAT.
I must say, it's super solid bit of kit. And I think I overheard you and your lovely colleague earlier. Should we touch on a bit more about your pedigree in the mastering world? Because obviously we've checked it out. We don't want to go too much into it. Obviously, you're going to, whoever buys it, is like you're saying, there's so much options, so there's no point really showing you my dodgy guitar playing or what we record with it. A little bit more about the company and about how, you know, your pedigree in mastering, something to do with the jitter and lack of, do you want to give us a bit of spiel about?
I think the jitter was referred to the quacking, actually.
Right, okay, yeah.
Yeah, the jitter, sorry. Actually, the jitter process is the errors which happens between the sample arrival and the sample start when it comes to the actual conversion process. In terms of the mastering, if you want to know more about it, we have two excellent mastering converters. The one is called Pure 2. All of our viewers can check it out on our website.
Cool.
It has Brown converters inside it. It has a soft clipping technology, and it has one of the highest possible mastering duct chips inside it as well. It is really a powerful unit when you want to finish the process of the mastering with it.
Yeah.
The other one is Eclipse 384, which is the first mastering converter which was able to record mastering session stems over 384 kilohertz, which is twice as 192.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah.
Hey, everyone at Andertons, thanks so much for checking out Antelope and with us today. I hope you got an idea of just how, the pedigree, how good this bit of kit is. And it's a shame you weren't in the store. If you weren't in the store, any thoughts of coming back over and doing more in-stores?
Yeah, of course. We have...
Well, it's great. You've already been over twice, haven't you?
Yeah, I have been here twice in a period of 6 months. So we'll be coming here again soon. Of course, we are here, we will announce it. We're doing demos of the latest interfaces from Antelope Audio. I'll be love to demo the new Orion 32 HD to new users to show the actual power of the unit, because the unit is really powerful. And I think that many of our viewers and subscribers will like it as it is.
Yeah, definitely one for the discerning chap, because I can see... I almost feel like I'm not up to the task in showing how good they are. But normally I'd leave us with a bit of dodgy music, but we're just going to have to end on a handshake now. And thanks so much. Check them out, Antelope Audio. Oh!